Good morning, guys. If I look tired, it's because I absolutely fucking am exhausted. We haven't gotten much sleep. We've been walking around all day, but I'm not complaining. But if I look tired, that's why. But today I'm gonna fulfill my teenage metalhead days. And if you don't know, this was me when I was like 17, 18. So yeah, I was all into the gothic metal. I still am very, like, you know, not as much as I used to, but I still enjoy the music. But ever since I was in Brazil and, you know, I was all into that, I knew that there was this church in the Czech Republic that was made out of human bones. Literally the whole inside of the church is made out of human bones, and it's called an ossuary, basically. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but anyway, it's an hour away from Prague, so that's what we're gonna do. And I'm gonna take you guys with me. So we're staying at this place that's actually like next door to the train station. We're gonna take a train that's about an hour to this little town where the church is. And we're gonna come back like, you know, early afternoon. So we still have a whole day in Prague. So I'm gonna take you guys with me. This is our second day here in Prague. So yeah, let's see the bone church. All right guys, so literally that's our hotel right here. The train station is right there. So if you do come to Prague by train, you're most likely gonna arrive at this train station. Our hotel is great, and I'll give you guys a more of a tour as well. Actually, let's go do a tour of the hotel right now. So this is our little hotel room here, guys, but we actually love the hotel. I would stay here in a heartbeat if I'm ever back in Prague. Very comfortable bed. There was a little table desk situation there, a little mini bar with espresso, a bottle of wine, if you're into coffee and that in the morning. A stocked mini fridge that I always love. I always said that I love cold water in the morning, so I love when rooms have this. Little shout out to Pedialyte for keeping us hydrated. Big window, especially because it was a little bit hot during the day, so we can just open up the windows. Always make sure to get those little European plugs, because the plugs there are very different than in the US. And then this is the bathroom. The bathroom was actually a huge bathroom compared to most places I've stayed in Europe. I would have probably made the bathroom a little bit smaller and the room a little bit bigger. But anyway, it was very comfortable. Hot showers. What's up? You know, it's a bathroom, a little sink, and the little magnifying mirror thingy. And then, yeah, there's like a big window here in the bathroom too, which was nice. So yeah, guys, that was our hotel room. You know, it's like, again, super close to the train station. It is about a 15-20 minute walk from like the main square and like Charles Bridge and all that. But we actually really like the hotel, especially for like, you know, it's a European size, so it's gonna be a little small. So yeah, but now let's walk over to the train station. And then from the train station, we're gonna figure out how to work the train station. It's like Czech is a hard language. We're gonna figure that out, and then we're gonna go to the bone church. This can be a little bit overwhelming, and I don't speak any Czech, so we're a little bit lost here. But if you check the number of your train, you know, the time of your train, the final destination, and the platform, it should be pretty self-explanatory. In the train, it was a little fun to figure out what platforms we're gonna go to, because I don't speak any Czech. It's a hard one, but with some help we found it with like 2 minutes to spare, and it's a 1 hour train ride to where we're going now. Yeah, pretty comfortable train. It's a pretty full train, so I don't want to show, you know, everybody, no privacy and all that. But anyway, yeah. And then we get there, and the guy's coming right now to scan our tickets. We're here. We're gonna walk probably around 15 minutes. So you get to this place called Kutna Ora. I think that's how you say it. I'm just gonna put it right here. So when you're booking tickets and stuff for the train, what I learned is if it says HL.N, it means that that's the main train station in the city. For example, when we left Prague, it literally said Praha, so P-R-A-H-A dot N-H-L. and that's the main train station there. So a lot of people come out, so if you're ever here, just follow everybody, because a lot of the people in the train left, you know, because they're all going to the same place. And then it's about, I believe, a 10-minute walk to the church. So we're walking down. If you ever come, you get out of the train station, you literally make a right and then follow the crowd. There's always gonna be a little bit of a crowd. When in Rome, you know, follow them. The weather is beautiful. I think it's probably like, I don't know, 65 degrees and sunny. I was wearing a sweater, but even took that off because I'm hot. Yeah, another thing that I wanted to say, restrooms in the Czech Republic are always gonna be paid. Kind of like Mexico, you know, how you do like pesos, I don't know, 5 pesos to get the restrooms and stuff. Here in the Czech Republic, you also pay, but a lot of restrooms accept cards. So you can pay the restroom with the card. But another thing that's funny here too that I noticed, nobody like swipes or even uses a chip here. It's all contactless. So it's just a tap, which some cards in the US do, but nobody really uses it. And every time I travel, I see how behind in the US we are with credit cards. Like, we feel like we just got the chips. So yeah, just make sure that your card has the tap thing, but you can also use Apple Pay almost everywhere. And when you buy your tickets, you can choose how many places you go. So I think there's actually 3 places you can visit: the church with the bones, a cemetery, and another church. And you can buy the tickets accordingly to what you want to do. We want to go to Prague, you know, early. So we're just going to the bone church, and we're actually heading back right now at 11:15. We just got here. And we're heading back at 1 to get there at 2. So you can do something where you stay here all day, or you can do something that you just stay here a couple of hours. I think this is the perfect time to come here too, because like the leaves are about to start changing. So it's super beautiful, and I bet in just a few more weeks everything's gonna be orange and red. So if you want to see those things, I would suggest coming to Prague, like, I don't know, end of October. So this is the church right here behind me that you can also visit, but you also need tickets to go to these churches. But like I said, we're only going to the one with the bones, which is that way right there. This is the church right here, and you're not supposed to take videos or pictures or anything like that, but I'm gonna put some videos, maybe some of mine, maybe some of the ones that are online and stuff, so you guys can see what it looks like inside. But yeah, you know, in my metal days, I was heard about this place and I always wanted to come, and I kind of forgot about it. And then I was researching about like what to do when we're here, and actually came across a Luisito Comunica video where he came here, and I was like, holy shit, that's the place that I, you know, used to read about and stuff. And just a little brief history. Basically, you know, this is back, dates back to the 1500s, and when they were building this chapel here behind us, they're building the chapel in the cemetery. And of course they uncovered mass graves with a lot of bones, so they kind of just put the lower part of the chapel, just all these bones. And I think it wasn't until like the 1700s that they hired a wood carver to kind of like, I don't know, arrange the bones, but he took the artistic liberty to make what you just saw right now. I'll show you guys what it looks like, which, you know, very like Dahmer-esque. That he got to play with all these bones and make chandeliers. So that chandelier contains every bone of the human body. They're estimated to be around 40,000 to 70,000 people, their bones in this church. So it's definitely a dark tourism place, which I think me and Michelle both considered ourselves a little bit. So we had to come here. But I know that it's not for everybody. I know it's a little creepy, macabre, and all that, but it's super interesting. You know, they're also saying that a lot of the bones here probably came from the Black Plague and all that, but I definitely recommend it if you are interested in that. Okay, so that was this little town right here where the ossuary is, where the bone church is, and the other stuff. But like I said, we were here for about an hour. So if you would like for you to just come here for an hour and still have most of the day in Prague, totally doable. You're just gonna be in a little bit of a hurry. We spent probably around, I'd say, what, 15 minutes in the ossuary, and then we basically walked to the cathedral. We were in the cathedral for less than 5 minutes, and now we're walking the 15 minute walk to the train station to get the train back to Prague. That takes about an hour. So very doable, but if you wanna spend more time here, super easy to. I highly recommend you download this app right here. I'm gonna put a link in the description as well for the app. And on that app, you can buy tickets for the subway system, for the buses. You can buy tickets to come here, like all the train stations, all the public transport of Prague, you can buy it there. And it's actually super easy to understand. When you get tickets, it is all in Prague, or it is all in Prague. It's all in Czech, where it tells you like the information of where the train is gonna take you, like platforms and all that. But with a little bit of, you know, asking somebody if they speak English very nicely, we were able to do it. So I'm sure you will too. But I highly recommend downloading that app because it makes your life a lot easier if you're doing the public transports here in Czech Republic. But Uber works here too. And then they also have like their own sort of Uber app for like taxis and stuff. And I'll put that app in the description as well. Oh, and another thing too, guys, the prices of everything. So the train here back and forth round trip for both of us was $20. So it's literally like $5 each way. And then for the church and the ossuary, I think it was $10, like $5 for that as well. So Czech Republic is pretty affordable compared to most of Europe, you know, when you're thinking like Germany, France, England. Another thing to note too is that they don't use the euros here. So they use the Czech crown. And right now in October 2022, the conversion rate is around 23-25 Czech crowns for a dollar. And like when you go to restaurants and stuff, a beer will cost you $3. You know, if it costs you $4 or $5, I've heard that you're getting scammed. But we've been going out, like we went to a, you know, world-class cocktail bar here, and that was like $70, and we each got about 4 cocktails. So even compared to LA, it's pretty affordable. I think it's pretty easy for us to forget the history of this place and things that happened here. I'm gonna show you this one memorial thing that we just saw, and I'm just gonna leave it at that. This farewell memorial is a symbol of courage and love of parents who in 1938 and 1939, regardless of what their own fate awaited them, boarded their children on trains and with heartache and tears in their eyes, waved goodbye, sending them away to safety to save their lives. Most parents perished in the Holocaust. All right, so we're back in Prague. If you remember, our hotel is like literally next to the station, so we're walking over to the hotel. It's gonna change really quick, and then we're gonna meet Laura and Tom. We're gonna go to a museum that they wanna go to, which should be cool. And then we're gonna probably grab a beer, hang out, and just stroll around, really. I wanna check how many steps we've done in the past 2 days, because my feet are killing me. So now right now we're in the city center. We hung out for a little bit, we had some coffee. Now we're just heading over to this place called the Red Stag. I'll put the Czech name right here, which is a brewery and some food, which actually, funny enough, I thought the reservations were yesterday and I showed up there, and it's actually for today. So we're gonna make sure that we're gonna go there. And this was actually, I found this out on Honest Guide. And if you guys are planning to go to Paris, of course, watch this video, but you should definitely watch the Honest Guides too, which are just two guys that make, you know, honest guides about Prague. So we're gonna go have some beer, check, and out. I had some coffee. I'm a little bit jittery.
This is probably one of my favorite dinners we had here in Prague, this at the Red Stag Brewery. This pastrami is delicious, a little meatball. That roasted beef, shredded beef thing was amazing. I went with the brisket. I know brisket in Prague, but it was honestly one of the best briskets I've ever had, like literally melting in your mouth. Michelle went the foie gras burger, even though she doesn't really eat foie gras, but she was missing a burger, I guess. Then we also had a little bit of like a steak with some gravy, some veggies right there. And then Laura went with some potatoes, pumpkins, and I think it was like a grilled eggplant. It was great, great dinner.
Guys, this awesome place used to be a bank, and now it's one of the best breweries here in Prague. And I definitely recommend you guys coming here. I'll put the name right here, of course. The link's gonna be in the description. This place is pretty awesome. The food was amazing. The beer was great. Service was also awesome.
And after that, we went over to the Hemingway bar. There's Hemingway bars all over the world. I don't know how much this guy used to drink, but it was a great cocktail bar with really good drinks. I definitely recommend getting a reservation if you're coming here so you're not waiting outside. But it was a great way to finish our night and have some really good cocktails. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Please make sure to like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. And if you have any questions about Prague, please message me on Instagram, and I'd be more than happy to answer those. Salucita.